Devon!
Oh my god, I saw you 2 days ago and I have done exactly what we agreed on. I've had the songs on a loop for 48 hours. What have you done?
I've had the songs on a loop for 48 hours and I finally reached my final decision, my top three of Eurovision, Junior Eurovision 2018. Shall we talk about it?
Let's do this!
Devon, this is so difficult, so I'm gonna kick this off with an honorable mention. My honorable mention goes to Albania. I love this song, Barbie. It's so funny, sweet. It has a strong ethnic identity and viewpoint. If you heard it, you might guess it was from Albania, and I think that deserves credit. The performer is sassy. When we hear the live performances, this could go higher and make it into my top three. For now, it's my honorable mention.
I agree. I think Effie is lovely. You know, her song is really child appropriate. She's full of fun, she's vivacious. And you know, she's got all those dolls in her bedroom and she's jumping up and down. Yeah. This is a song that many children relate to. And adults who love childlike qualities in children will love this.
She's not your toy. Who's your honorable mention?
My honorable mention is Kazakhstan, Daniela Tulishova. Oh. Girl, what a debut. What a debut. She can sing. Her vocals are like, I heard her and I was like, wow. Clear vocals, powerful song, inspirational, uplifting. It blows me away.
She's on another level. It is so good. She was also my other honorable mention, so we're thinking along the same lines. I think Kazakhstan is going to invest a lot in her performance because they want to make a splash, and I think they will.
And they've chosen well. They've really chosen well.
She seems so confident.
And I like what you said earlier in our previous review, which you can see the videos on Wooey Blogs. She could be from anywhere.
Yeah, Russia, Kazakhstan, London, England, you know, Finland. She's got a global look. All right, so time for our top three. My number three goes to...
Drum roll!
Or should I say my number trois? It goes to France.
Oh, wow.
Jamais sans toi, she is so good, so vivacious, so lively, so sweet, so on point. I think this song is very well produced, very happy, it makes you smile. It doesn't seem to last 3 minutes, it feels like 90 seconds because you are with her the entire time. My only concern is that in the instrumentals, where it's quite happy and you want to, you know, dance, on stage, that could be boring, so they just need to make sure the producers, this is nothing about her, the producers need to make sure they do interesting cuts and have some interesting visuals to keep your attention, because she sells her part real well.
And France is often the victim of bad staging. Like,
yes.
They normally get the song right, the artist right, everything right, but the staging could just be better.
It just consistently doesn't work.
Yeah.
But I love this song, how it has, you know, it starts off almost like an Alma Requiem. There's a very strong French
identity.
It's great.
It's great.
Then it goes to Tropical House. You know, she ain't in the schoolhouse, she's in the Tropical House. It's just so fresh, so fun. The message applies to friends, it applies to boys, to girls, to adults, to, you know, you can apply it to so many different demographics. I think
it's great.
Yeah, she sells all of it, so well done. Vive la France!
Absolutely. Moving on to my number three, cue drum roll. Anyone I want to be. Roxana from Poland is
excellent.
One girl I want to be.
I speak my heart and I know I can be anyone I want to be. Life's never really that cold, wise.
I find her sassy, confident, bold. The song is melodious, it's punchy. It's just so great. And you know, she's just badass. She kicks it. She's cool.
Kills it.
I think this is really, really good. This is a real stand-up from Poland. You know, I think Poland, yeah. What last year was like Olivia the Balladeer, beautiful, but they've gone in a different direction.
That was 2 years ago.
2 years ago? Who was it last year?
It was also a Balladeer.
Okay, so I'm glad they've kind of revisited the sort of the casting page and they've gone for something a bit more upbeat and funny. She wears braces. She's so cute.
Showcasing they can do many genres.
Absolutely.
This is a really good entry. Feminine but strong, girly yes. but masculine. You know it's got the rock edge. It's fantastic.
And she's Roxana.
She's killing it.
How can you go wrong?
Roxana Lavigne.
Yeah, I love her.
My number two is Russia.
Whoa!
It's really good. It's Unbreakable. Good, she is strong. This song is so well produced, so well sung, just so 2018. You know, it's interesting. When the chorus starts, there's a swell of many voices. It kind of nods to Russia's tradition of We Are the World peace songs at the adult Eurovision, but this doesn't feel cliche.
No.
It does not feel cliche. It feels original and fresh. This song could stand its own at the adult Eurovision. I think it is absolutely wonderful.
But yet not misplaced at junior, because yeah. It has that high school musical quality.
Perfectly placed. Perfectly placed. I love her pink and blue braids, a strong woman, a little bit of Dina Na, a little bit of Rona Nishalu, but all about her. Okay, she's slaying, she's serving. If this won, it would be deserved. Strong entry. Russia, give her good staging. She deserves it.
And I agree. My number two is... I Wanna Be Like You, babe.
Oh, yes.
Fidan Hüseynova, my God.
Salam Baku.
And you could well be taking us to Baku. This is such a strong entry. It is so likable. It is so relatable. It's very rare for me to just feel like, oh God, you're so sweet, so adorable. I feel like I'm some sort of big uncle who wants to take you out to the amusement park and buy you lots of candy floss. This is so lovely, you know?
There's a sincerity to her performance.
Endearing. It's adorable. It's sweet. It's inviting. It's touching. It's playful. It's fun.
Pure.
It's complimentary. Yeah. You know, I want to be like you.
It fits her. It's very pure. And I think there's almost a spiritual quality as well.
Oh, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? On the video shot on the Caspian Sea, the water flowing, her singing, the smile beaming. God bless the children.
Oh, God bless the child. And yes. You got your own. That is just so, so good. And I love the other observation which you made. There's nothing flashy about it. There's no makeup. Yeah. It's just... pure.
Yeah, they could have gone all Flame Towers. Baku knows how to do OTT.
Yeah,
they didn't. They deliberately kept this simple. Sometimes you gotta pull back, and they did.
Yeah.
All right, Devin, it's time for our number one.
Yeah.
And before we reveal... I've been hiding this big old flag for weeks.
There's green in it.
Oh no, that's gonna not work so well. But look, this was a hard decision because any of my top five could have been my number one depending on the day and my mood.
Wow.
But my number one...
Why don't you get that megaphone?
I'm gonna get the megaphone, girl. I'm flying from Moscow and I'm headed to Kiev. My number one is Ukraine. I say love, not war. You say love, not war. We say love, not war. Hey, let down your arms, people of the universe.
Ukraine!
This song is unreal. It almost feels rebellious. You know, you've got this sweet child dressed in urban kind of thug wear, essentially.
She's amazing.
She's owning it with pure swagger, contrasting her sweetness. It's a protest anthem. The saying, you know, make love, not war, she's essentially playing off of that.
I mean, Doreena's so cool, isn't she?
She's so cool. She's playing off this anthem from the 60s and 70s and making it her own. There's a Jamala quality to the opening. Spiritual, silent, ethnic. There's a wailing that comes out, and yet it doesn't feel like a regional song. It feels very current because they have this electropop, dark arts, Robin of Sweden edge. It's dark Robin. Do you know what I'm saying? Dark Robin, Sweden to Ukraine via Jamala. It's all about her though. All these things are going on, and yet I'm still focused on her. She sells every moment of this song. Every moment.
Do you know though, like Ukraine, one of my favorite junior Eurovision entries of all time is a Ukrainian song. Do you
want to
get Anna Trincha?
Oh, she's amazing. The lotus flower that she emerged from in Bulgaria 2015. She deserved to come much higher. Junior Eurovision is impossible to predict because adult tastes are obviously different from the tastes of children, like people assessing a song contest for children. It's all very complicated.
And when we threw the Wee Wee Jam in Kiev, we decided we're actually going to invite Anna Trincha because
she
we didn't
it.
Think she was actually junior. You know,
No. Her level of talent was never juvenile. It was always adult. She's so good. She's so good, and she continues to slay. But look, focusing on this artist, Doreena kills it. Her call for peace is filled with fire.
It's excellent. It really is good.
I'm feeling the burn.
So good.
I could listen to that song and watch that over and over on loop. Again, that's the type of song with the right staging that could compete at the adult contest. It is magical.
Absolutely.
It is magical.
And certainly the staging concept is so gripping that that really ought to translate.
Yeah, it was in the video we saw, it was very Helena Marai 2017. I think that came fifth last year. And one of our readers told me, I was always saying, oh, it's too adult for kids. And he pointed out, well, actually in the Netherlands, kids and teenagers listen to music that is like this. And so it's hard to predict what people will like. I just know
that it sounds adult to me.
That song appeals to me.
That's why I like it. Yeah.
It appeals to me, and I think it's wonderful. I wish her all the best.
Right, drum roll for my number one position, which is your numero trois from Angelina.
Amazing.
Jamais sans toi. You know, you've said all the things that I want to say, but I'll just add to that exhilarating, enheartening, reassuring, bright, danceable, enlivened my soul. The transition from French to English and back to French.
Amazing.
It's so smooth and unnoticeable and just not obvious.
She's confident in English.
Oh, she's just so great. And I like the community aspect of this where, you know, she can do it solo, she can do it with, you know, looking at a friend next door. You don't get an inappropriate sense of affection. It's excellent.
We say it all the time, age appropriate.
You know, France, Eurovision, certainly in the last 3-4 years, have slayed consistently, even though the results haven't embraced their effort.
They've slayed musically.
Yes.
Visually, it's
hit or miss.
Yeah.
However, again, we're just judging by what we have, which is, again, a banging studio cut. And for junior level, honestly,
it's so happy.
If France gets numero uno on this,
deserved.
And I'm happy with that.
It would be amazing. It would be amazing. Now look, this is our top three after watching the studio cuts.
For 2 days.
Studio cuts. We will do another top three slash jury review, as we always do, closer to the final. And things could change drastically when we hear people live and we see the staging.
Also, we are running Wee Wee Jury polls and opinion pieces on the website, so do make sure to check in and read those too. And that's a much more comprehensive review involving several Wee Wee bloggers.
Yeah. Final point, keep it cute or put it on mute. we are not tolerating shade against these young contestants. So if you put some nasty comments in this video,
you will be deleted
and you will be blocked. People always say, oh, it's my freedom of speech. It's against the law to block me. No, people misunderstand freedom of speech. You have the right to say whatever you would like. I do not have to listen to it. That is also my right, and I can press delete.
Can I just say he doesn't listen to it, but our moderator don't play.
Our moderator don't play. You will be blocked. In any case,
follow us on
Facebook,
Instagram,
Twitter,
Tumblr,
and here
YouTube.
On YouTube. And then follow me and Devin as well. Our links are in the description down below. William Lee Adams on Instagram, Willie Lee Adams on Twitter,
and Devin Adoremi and Devin_Devin on Instagram.
We'll see you later.